every single day. I wake early, I read, I write, and then I exercise. And that's not a flex. I've just found that through all my years of experimentation,
is that that is the winning combo for me.
And when I say I've experimented, I mean I've experimented, trust me. Because getting an opinion is not enough.
You've got to beta test it. You've got to be patient and then willing to do the work. It's about the data. You need to be systematic and methodical to find out what works for you. I talk about this a lot, but it's about cracking your code. Your code. Everyone has a code, and I've cracked mine. If we're talking off the kit, waking early, reading, writing, and then exercising, that's the perfect order for me to have a great day. Basically, because the intention's been set for the day on my terms. Now, if we're talking on the kit, a healthy pursuit of chops and facility, like my last video with Meshuggah, coupled with a dedicated interest in feel and pocket, and man, you're laughing. But with feel and pocket, much like everything else, you have to put the work in. We're going to need two of these. And how do we do that? How do we practice feel and pocket? Well, firstly, you have to find a song that, in your opinion, has feel and pocket. And then, look, I'm sorry to say, but you've got to play that song to death. To death. And one track that I've always used for that is none other than Jeff Buckley's Everybody Here Wants You. If you want to listen and feel pocket and timing, this is the track to do it with. Now, much like Massive Attack's teardrop video that I did, I want the hats to be a little bit more reserved. So I'm going to use a hot rod, and I'm also going to use a trusty 7A. I mean, what better way to follow up Meshuggah's chorus to Stinger than with Jeff Buckley's Everybody Here Wants You? It's perfect. And the dichotomy of the two brings up a really good point too. And that's that a good song is a good song, regardless of the genre. With mics, I love experimenting. And I find often with the kick drum that if I put a mic here, I can get a lower fundamental frequency. And then what I want to do with the second Dynacaster is put it here so I can get the attack of the kick drum, the body of the snare, and less of the hats. I also want a little more mass in my kick drum, so I'm going to use the K-drums beater. It'll just assist in getting that lower fundamental that I was talking about. And as always, I'm going to buy the track, remove the drums with Moise's AI, and then I suppose we just got to get into it.
Coffee smelling lilac skin, you're flaming me. Twenty-nine pearls in your kiss, a singing smile. Coffee smelling lilac skin, you're flaming me. I'm only this moment. I know everybody here wants you. I know everybody here thinks he needs you. such a thing of wonder in this crowd. I'm a stranger in this town. You're free with me. And our eyes locked in outcast love, I sit here proud. Even now you're undressed in your dreams with me. I'm only here for this moment. I know everybody here wants you.
And that is it. Once again, our two mic setup is done. And I have to say too, these Dynacasters are just blowing my mind with their versatility. And then the other thing to point out is that no click track was used, and there's absolutely no editing on the drums as well. I was going purely for vibe. All right, that's it for this video. I really wanted to flip this one on its head, and what better way to do that than going from Meshuggah all the way to Jeff Buckley. And I really adore that song, so that was a lot of fun. Thanks to everyone for the comments, the shares and the likes of the ones that I've done so far. I really appreciate it, and I will see you at the next one. Cheers.